So once again, I am here with some new lecture. As you know, in my last lecture I told you about the data types and I told you how to find out the minimum and maximum value of any data type. But that was the case of unsigned values or unsigned data type. But this time I am going to cover in which way you have to find out the minimum value and maximum value if data type is signed. So just I am switching my screen and you will be seeing that so this time same example I am taking. There is one variable that is taking 2 bits. Means size of data type is 2 bits only. So in that case you will be seeing that 00, total number of discrete values are 0110 and 11. Now in case of unsigned, you will be seeing the total values are 4, minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 3. But when the data type is signed, then 50% of values they will become positive and 50% of values they will become negative. So there is a formula as we discussed in the last class, 2 to the power n total values if case is unsigned. If case is signed, in that case the formula will be 2 to the power n total values but total positive values or negative values will be equal to 2 to the power n by 2. Means for the case of 2 bits data type, for 2 bits data type, positive total values equal to 2 to the power 2 by 2 equal to 2 and negative total values equal to 2 to the power 2 by 2 equal to 2. So total positive values are 2 and total negative values are 2 and complete total values are 4. So now I have to find out minimum positive value. It will be equal to, according to the formula, 2 to the power n by 2 minimum. Okay, no, minimum value will be 0 always. Maximum positive value equal to, according to the formula, 2 to the power n by 2 minus 1. So just move it here and now you can see for 2 bits it will be 2 to the power 2 by 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Now in next, minimum value with negative sign I am saying here in some different way that minimum value with negative sign. Otherwise, if I am saying minus 1 and minus 2, which one is bigger? Minus 1 is bigger and minus 2 is smaller. That is why I am saying, because otherwise all the audience will be little bit confused, that minimum value with negative sign. So that will be always minus 1. Maximum value with negative sign equal to 2 to the power n by 2 with negative sign. Just I have to put negative sign. So, particularly in my case, when I am taking a data type of size 2 bits only, so it will be negative 2 to the power 2 by 2 equal to minus 2. So, for 2 bits size data type, for 2 bits size data type, I can say 0 and 1 positive, for negative minus 1 and minus 2 they will be negative. So this will be the case. Same, this is my first case. What is in second? 2, not 2 is this time, 3 bits, 3 bit size data type, negative minimum, negative minimum, you can say negative minimum will be minus 1, negative, you can understand my view there, that minimum value with negative sign, minimum value with negative sign, maximum value with negative sign. So maximum, I am speaking this in some different way, it will be 2 to the power n by 2, but as I told you, I have to put negative sign, so it will be equal to negative 2 to the power 3 by 2 equal to minus 4. Now, just you can see it in this way. Now, I am writing plus positive minimum value equal to positive minimum value, that will be always 0, positive maximum value equal to, positive maximum value will be equal to 2 to the power n by 2 minus 1, and it will be equal to 2 to the power 3 by 2 minus 1 equal to, it will be equal to 4 minus 1. So now, in which way I have to represent all the values? 0, 1, 2 and 3, all positive, and 1, 2, 3 and 4, minus 3, minus 3, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1, all are positive, negative. So now you can find out for integer, byte, double, float, but as I told you, the calculation of finding that 2 to the power n, that will not be easy on paper, that will be something difficult, you have to do some effort for that. If you are having any doubt, then you can contact me, you can write a query, you can give a comment to me, and I will be explaining it to you. Naturally, if you are saying to me that please find out for integer, find out for byte, find out for double, at this place I am not telling you the exactly, because such type of things are written in the book very easily, you will get the values. But I told you the method that is not easily available everywhere. I am not saying this is my invention, but naturally that will be difficult. And I found it in according to my experience, many students are not aware with this technique. Just they are memorizing what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, and they are writing wrongly. But only memorizing is not necessary. What is the necessary thing? They have to know how to find out it, so that in future that can be utilized somewhere in high competition or wherever it is required. So thank you once again. Like my channel, subscribe my channel, share my videos, and if you have any doubt, then you can put that in comment section. 100% I will be answering to you, and I will be clearing your all the doubts. Thank you.